at nerves of steel. Agatha June flies like a dove, strikes like a falcon. A match for the strongest on the team. Hoodow, hoodie to his friends. Wisecracking navigator who flies the amazing rocket ship Phoenix and laughs at danger. Pee-wee, small and bold as a merlin, the tiniest hawk of them all. These are the adventures of G-Force. Five secret agents trained to fly like birds. G-Force, guardians of space.
This is Mantle One. We're flying over the deserted city now. We're just about ready to begin checking for any signs of life that could survive that pollution.
Roger, Mantle One. You are cleared to begin testing according to plan.
Yes, sir. All right, let's begin the test. Transmit all data directly to Dr. Brighthead's underwater base.
Here come the readings from Mantle One.
Anderson, conditions are worse than I dared expect.
For the team to remain any longer might endanger them.
At 500 feet, very unusual smog hanging over the city. The farther we go, the denser it gets. 200 parts per unit. 300. 350.
That's enough, Mantle One. Stop your survey and return to base at once.
Well, with your permission, Dr. Brighthead, we'd like to finish the smog survey. I thought we'd go down to about 100 feet.
Don't do it. Too risky.
Shouldn't be that risky, sir. The ship is well insulated.
You're well insulated against deadly gases that we know about, but who knows what you'll find down there?
Setting down at City Hall.
What do you mean you're setting that helicopter down at City Hall? You're to cease the survey and return immediately to your base.
Computer. Dr. Brighthead's survey team is completely wiped out.
So it should be, Galactor. In this way, you will conquer Earth. No one must enter the Ghost City.
No one.
See, the Phoenix is sprayed with special protective gold leaf to block the entry of poison gas. That's what gives it that yellow glow. That coating is necessary because you'll be flying through extremely poisonous gas. No one can predict what'll happen to it out there. You must be extremely careful when you go to investigate the mystery.
Mm-hmm. You bet, sir.
Good luck.
Thanks. Okay, let's blast off, G-Force.
Let's go!
G-Force, transform! Climb, Hootie. What a barren place.
I've seen places like that upon the moon, but never upon the Earth.
If the Science Foundation had been set up earlier, that never would have happened, I bet.
Excessive pollution is responsible for that. They just never paid much attention to the needs of the Earth.
Couldn't have said it better. Say, we're getting close to the place where that Mantle One helicopter was stormed.
Is it possible there are actually human beings that can live in this poisonous atmosphere?
Those wrecks may just be relics of ancient accidents. Keep looking for Mantle One. We're at the town square near City Hall. This is where the helicopter vanished. Hootie, give me magnification on those statues. Hey, that head looks new. I don't think this place is as deserted as it looks. Those guns are aimed at us! Galactor's men!
Watch out!
Boy, we're lucky we got out of that one. We'd have been goners if that building hadn't been corroded.
Uh-oh, look at our wing!
It's okay, the protective coating has come off, that's all.
Boy, I was scared. That protective coating really saved us.
Well, now we know that the abandoned Ghost City is really Galactor's secret base.
Let's go back to Town Square. Give them tit for tat.
We can't. Our mission, as you know, is limited to locating Galactor's secret base. Now, wiping out that Ghost City will be Operation Brown.
Operation Brown has destroyed your base in the Ghost City. The work of Dr. Brighthead.
What?
However, all is not lost. Earthlings have polluted not only their land, but their seas as well. In their polluted waters, development of the giant jellyfish lens has been a great success. Decaying protoplasm has been made to form into jellyfish that grow larger and larger, more and more powerful.
I shall use that power.
Should we turn on full power?
Yes. Is working. The jellyfish lens is opening.
We're flying over the Ghost City. Pollution level still high. No sign of... Wait, what's that? Something weird rising from the sea! Attention all aircraft! Unidentified flying object coming to attack! All right! Let's get it, men!
What? Giant jellyfish lens? You're not serious.
I wish it were a joke,
We've intercepted some of Galactor's transmissions. He calls his newest deadly weapon the Jellyfish Lens. Now he wants to show us what'll happen if we try to stand up to that weapon. Look at the screen. Right after Galactor wiped out our air squadron, he went to other cities. A resident took this film. They're watching a UFO, which we know is the Jellyfish Lens. That lens magnifies sunlight and can focus it into a powerful beam of destruction. Watch. Now you see why Galactor must be stopped. This is a small part of the damage done by Galactor's so-called jellyfish lens. A lens that focuses the sun's rays into a beam of destruction. When we look through an infrared filter, we see that it looks like a diamond.
Tell me, Doctor, to me that lens appears to be living tissue. What is it made of?
Well, it certainly is no ordinary lens. It's a crystal, all right, but shaped like an eye. My guess is it's composed of pollutants from the sea combined with the tissue of a jellyfish.
The sooner we finish it, the better.
I agree. Let's get G-Force on the trail of that jellyfish lens immediately.
Right. What are you waiting for, Ace?
Everybody aboard the Phoenix.
Okay, we're over the harbor of the Ghost City.
Gee, we should have searched under the sea. Let's do it now. Close the vents, Hootie.
That water looks mighty polluted. You think the Phoenix can take it?
Don't worry. The protective gold coat developed by Dr. Brighthead will work well underwater.
We're submerging, gang.
Look at all that gunk. Are you sure the Phoenix can withstand all that?
Pee-wee, you need to have more confidence in the achievements of science.
Yeah? That polluted water is also an achievement of science, Aggie.
That's right. Some kind of genius that Galactor is to create a new kind of life from a poisoned sea.
Hey, there's something out there.
Maybe it's Galactor's jellyfish lens. Keep her quiet, Hootie, so we're not detected.
Carlton Food Network, television to tempt your taste buds. Carlton Select, the best TV on TV. Channel 1, news you can use. Performance, the arts channel. The Sci-Fi Channel, all things science fiction. Travel, TV that takes you there. Live TV, television right across Britain. Cable television, the choice is yours.
Telephoto. See if we can pick up the jellyfish lens. Ah!
That's the jellyfish lens.
There are two of them.
No, four. Or five. I see more. Hey, look at that! Cell division. They're multiplying. They're growing before our very eyes.
If they keep on growing at that incredible speed, there'll be hundreds of them within a matter of hours. Hundreds.
We have to stop them.
Can't those jellyfish lenses be made to grow faster?
Not on Earth, Great Galactor. But they are growing faster than mankind's ability to control them. Soon they will overrun the seas. Then they will overrun the continents. Planet Earth will be yours.
We're surrounded!
I think it's too late for anyone on Earth to do anything about this.
But the jellyfish are still in the sea, and that gives us a good chance, I think.
Think it would do any good to hit them with a bird missile?
Too dangerous. Firing the missile at this depth could create tremendous pressure that could crush us.
Right, no bird missile.
What's left?
We could zoom to the surface after we fire it.
That might do it, Dirk, and I've already got Dr. Brighthead's permission.
Then here we go.
Prepare to fire the bird missile.
Roger.
10 degrees, that's a pretty sharp angle.
That's what it takes, though, Dirk, to get every last jellyfish.
Fire! Red alert! Oh! The creatures are eating away our protective coating! Speed up, Hootie! Increase the pressure to try and shake them off!
I'll try!
Great, we just made it. Good, Hootie.
That's my style.
Well, let's not relax just yet. We're not back at our submarine base.
Uh-oh. There they are. They won't give up.
Ah! They're regrouping! This is bad. Remember, they have the ability to focus the sun's rays into a deadly beam of total destruction.
Oh, boy.
Ah! Jellyfish lens. What are you up to now, creation of Galactor?
Some kind of gas!
Get above it, Hootie, before it attacks those spots where we lost the protective coating. Ace, we might have to fire another bird missile at it. No, that would only break it up again.
Listen, G-Force, we've discovered that those creatures must breathe that deadly gas in order to live, so if you blow that gas away somehow, your chances of getting away are guaranteed, and we wipe out the jellyfish lens forever. The squad we call Red Impulse will be along soon to help you, so stand by.
Oh yeah, Red Impulse.
Impulse to G-Force. What we have up here is pure oxygen. We'll drop it in the center of those jellyfish lenses. The rest is up to you folks.
That's fine. Aggie, prepare to go to Firebird mode.
What? Ace, why?
Why?
Ace, you can't go into Firebird mode on this baby the way she is now. She's unprotected. She can't take it. She'll fall apart.
And if we plunge into pure oxygen, you know what'll happen? We'll burn to ashes. We have no choice.
They're changing color, getting ready to zap us.
Don't expect us to sit here and just be zapped, you turkeys!
Bombs away!
Firebird mode, now!
We made it. We won the fight. The jellyfish lens has blown up. All okay?
All okay.
All for one and one for all.
All for one and one for all.
Well done, G-Force.
Well, G-Force, you've done another fine job. We're indebted to you all.
Thanks.
By the way, you'll be interested to learn that the International Science Foundation wants to turn the Ghost City back into a green city. They're sure they have the know-how to be able to do it.
Glad to hear that, sir. That's good news.
Once again, thank you. You're doing good work.
Hey, why don't we make one more pass over the abandoned city? Give us one more chance to see it before it becomes a green city.
We don't dare go back there again. The poor ship could never take it.
Don't worry, Aggie. The Phoenix is built to go anywhere and do anything we command her to. She's tough.
Let's go!
We're going.
Teenage champions, G-Force, guardians of space, fighting for good over evil, fighting to defend planet Earth from deadly enemies from space. Ace Goodheart, leader of the team, strong, vigilant, fearless as a hawk, guarding the four young agents under his command. Dirk Gehring, second in command, a crack marksman with the eye of an eagle and nerves of steel. Agatha June, flies like a dove, strikes like a falcon. A match for the strongest on the team. Hoodow, hoodie to his friends, wisecracking navigator who flies the amazing rocket ship Phoenix and laughs at danger. Pee-wee, small and bold as a merlin, the tiniest hawk of them all. These are the adventures of G-Force. Five secret agents trained to fly like birds. G-Force, guardians of space.
Lector, Dr. Brighthead has completed construction of the most modern automated factory on their planet. It requires more power to operate than a small city, and yet does so at half the cost. Inside, you will find the state of the art in human automation. The factory constructs remotely controlled machines for doing work in places too dangerous for humans to go. Since there are almost no human workers within the factory itself, it should be quite easy for you to take over and set up for your own purpose. But you must act quickly, for once the alarm systems are fully operating, your takeover of the factory will be nearly impossible.
Computer, my forces have entered the factory. It was indeed easy.
Good, Galactor. Now you must act before the Earthlings discover your plan. You must act quickly. Take the humans by surprise before they have a chance to prepare their defenses.
Yes. Activate the final phase.
Yes, sir. Activate the inducing system. Power levels to maximum.
He's out of control! Get out, boy!
Did you see that? The robots attacked us!
robots. It looks like they're putting something together.
What in the world do you think they're building? Their speed is incredible.
Hey, what's going on?
Earthlings, as you can see, I have borrowed this super automated factory of yours in order to do a little manufacturing of my own. With your tools, I made myself a pet. He will be the tool of your destruction.
Immediately, we have an emergency.
G-Force, transform!
Surrounded. I suppose I ought to give up now and turn myself in.
What a maniac! I'll show him.
G-Force, you shall pay for that little stunt.
Roger.
What a fun machine this is, huh?
That contraption disappear.
According to our radar, it was headed down the highway in this direction.
Hey, look! There's a tunnel up ahead. See? It must have gone in there.
No way, Pee-wee. You saw how big that thing was. How in the world is it gonna fit?
Huh. I don't know. Maybe it's able to shrink itself somehow.
I doubt that's possible. What do you think, Ace?
I know one thing. It disappeared from our radar in this area. Let's split up the search effort, and later we'll all meet at Dr. Brighthead's and put it all together, okay?
They think that because I'm the youngest, I couldn't have a good idea for a change. Well, I'll show them. I just know that thing's in there.
Look at this. They must have gone in before the alarm systems were fully installed and reprogrammed all the robots. What an evil mind. Do you know how many millions of dollars went into that factory just so he could use it to build a new weapon? We found one of these inside the logic centers of each robot that worked at the factory. We think it's a remote control device Galactor used to control the robots.
Dr. Brighthead, just what kind of weapon has Galactor built?
Based on the robot's new programming, I'd say he's built a machine that can reconstruct itself.
You mean like the way the Phoenix can change over to Firebird mode?
No. Not exactly. It seems that their system is based on super speed production of any machine of which they can make a working diagram and transfer to microfilm. The microfilm is encased in a cassette that, when read by a computer, is transformed into the new machine using our parts.
Well then, how can we defeat something like that?
The only thing we can't get from the robots is the type of microfilm they're using. If we knew that, there'd be a way we could win.
A light up ahead. Maybe I've stumbled onto something. I knew it. There's something down there. I'll bet anything it's Galactor's secret base. Ah! Shoulder. Hey, that thing, it's disappeared. I must have passed out when I hit the floor. Now I'm gonna have to search this whole darn place. Strange, there's nobody here.
Good, Master, good. Tear the Earthlings' planet apart.
This is even better than the wrestling matches on human television.
Doctor, Galactor's monster is raiding a metal alloy refinery.
Interesting, G1. He's probably after the newly developed super-strong titanium made there.
Why would he be after that?
Could be what that thing uses whenever it reconstructs itself. No telling what it'll turn into next. You'd better head back.
On my way.
Those rats. I've got half a mind to take out this secret base all on my own. Ah! My lucky day! One laser gun. Coming up. Ha! This ought to liven things up a bit. When you've got a laser gun, who needs karate? This computer needs a trim. A little off the top, please. Thank you.
The armory's on fire. Get a squad on.
You, get the film out of the designing room, quick!
Hey, what kind of film is this?
Hey!
Oh, better get out of here.
Give me that film, hey!
So, you want the film, eh? This film must be pretty important stuff for you to want it back so badly. Sorry, guys, but I'm gonna hold on to it. Bye-bye, fellas.
Hey! He's headed for the hangar area.
That's what you get for picking on somebody smaller than yourself. Oh, here's your gun back. Everyone.
Pee-wee! Are you all right?
What happened to you? Where have you been?
I found Galactor's secret base and I blew it up.
You blew it up? By yourself? You gotta be kidding. Oh. Pee-wee, what have you got here?
Just some film I found in a room with a bunch of drawings in it. They wanted it back real bad.
This is it. We've got it. This is the microfilm that Galactor uses to reconstruct his mechanism. Did you hear me, Pee-wee? You're a hero.
Really?
Fools! Dolts! All of you knew how important that microfilm was. For this blunder, you will all be reassigned to my secret base at the North Pole.
Please don't, Master. I have thin blood.
Then I suggest you get yourself a pair of warm mittens.
This cassette is just like the one Galactor uses in his robot. The only difference is the drawing on the microfilm inside, which I reprogrammed. Do you know what to do?
If I'm reading you correctly, Doctor, you somehow want me to get on board that thing and slip this in the computer.
Mm-hmm. Won't be easy.
I can do it.
Today will be remembered as the day I did away with G-Force once and for all.
Inside that thing if we can't get close to it.
He's right. Any closer and we'll get fried.
Ace, maybe we should think this over. Come up with another plan.
I agree. I don't like the idea of you anywhere near that thing.
We must be patient.
Don't give up yet, G-Force.
If I could, Ace, I'd go in there with you.
There seems to be no way into that monster, but there has to be an opening somewhere on its surface. Only where? There has to be an opening somewhere on its surface.
I've got an idea.
All right.
There's a way I can make it in there. Whenever that monster reconstructs itself, you see all kinds of openings to the inside. That's when I go in.
All right, then. We're in.
come in just a little closer, G-Force. I could use a little more practice with my new weapon.
Now, Hootie, go in! Weapon is harmless, Galactor. It's just been reprogrammed.
What will you do now?
Don't worry, Galactor. I'm not going to harm you. What I am going to do, though, is turn you over to the authorities, and they'll probably lock you up for a long time and throw away the key.
Really?
Hey!
No humans will ever imprison Galactor.
Don't you bet on it.
Kiddie rides, Ferris wheels, roller coasters, merry-go-rounds. Who would have thought that Dr. Benjamin Brighthead, world-renowned scholar, mathematician, physicist, all-around scientist, would have placed a design for a carnival in that cassette he gave me. I guess you really can't judge a book by its cover.
Teenage champions, G-Force, guardians of space, fighting for good over evil, fighting to defend planet Earth from deadly enemies from space. Ace Goodheart, leader of the team, strong, vigilant, fearless as a hawk, guarding the four young agents under his command. Dirk Gehring, second in command, a crack marksman with the eye of an eagle and nerves of steel. Agatha June, flies like a dove, strikes like a falcon. A match for the strongest on the team. Hoodow, hoodie to his friends, wisecracking Danigator who flies the amazing rocket ship Phoenix and laughs at danger. Pee-wee, small and bold as a Merlin, the tiniest hawk of them all. These are the adventures of G-Force. Five secret agents trained to fly like birds. G-Force, guardians of space.
I have finished my analysis of the human population of planet Earth. From the earliest periods of human history, people have had a destructive instinct. Even very young children act out their urge to destroy. Harness this destructive force, Galactor, and you can conquer the Earth.
Let's go! Yeah.
Let's get him!
Hey! What are you doing on there?
Stop right now and get down! I'm calling your parents!
Let's go!
Come back here, that's an order! We won't be able to catch them.
They know their way around here better than we do.
Control the children of Earth. Use their destructive power.
Oh, I'm bored, you guys. What are we gonna do? We can't just hang out. Oh boy. What a drag. Hey, look at this. This beetle's gotta be the weirdest one in the world. Skipper, check it out.
Tommy, I found an even bigger one over here.
I caught another one, you guys.
Hey, cool. Mine's bigger
Whoa.
Than you guys.
Hey, check
Come on,
it
let's
out.
Go.
Oh,
hey, wait for me, you guys.
Well, the way things are going, I'm not gonna find any insects for my science project. I might just as well give up.
Hey! Oh, look at that! It's a beetle! I'll be able to get an A in biology after all! Great! Something tells me this little bug is gonna be the big star of my next science fair project.
Oh, get that thing out of here, Pee-wee!
Gee, Aggie, you can hurt their feelings if you hit helpless little bugs.
Well, I'm gonna hurt more than its feelings if you don't get that beetle out of my snack shop this very minute.
I'll be fair about this, Aggie. This little guy's my pal.
I'll take your pal back out into the street where he belongs.
Okay. She just pretends she's a scientist. But I won't leave you outside. I'll just hide you in my room.
Was that noise? It must have been Pee-wee falling out of bed again. Nothing to worry about.
I sure hope he outgrows that habit.
well done, Lieutenant. The Beetle strategy seems to be working perfectly.
Ah, but it is your brilliant idea that is making our victory possible, mighty Galactor. Only you would think of using children's brains to power a robot.
You are wise to fuel your warships with the destructive power of Earth's children. But be careful, Galactor. G-Force has spoiled your plans before.
Yes, Computor. But even if G-Force does arrive on the scene, it will be far too late to stop me.
Pee-wee, what's the matter with you? It's 12 o'clock and time for you to get out of bed. Come on, sleepyhead. Pee-wee, is this a trick? Hmm? My goodness, the pattern in that glass makes it look like it was shattered from the inside. What's going on? His G-Force trans power band. This is very mysterious. I think I'd better go visit Dr. Brighthead.
Power plant's burning up. Now he could win a prize as the world's biggest bug.
Hey, that bug's got booster rockets.
Dr. Brighthead, this is Ace calling. It's an emergency.
Go ahead, Ace.
A Beetle robot is attacking the power plant. You need to dispatch G-Force to the site right away.
Sorry, I can't do that right now.
What's the matter, Doctor? I said it was an emergency.
We have an emergency of our own here. Pee-wee's disappeared.
What do you mean?
It's true, Ace. I think he's been kidnapped. Look, Pee-wee wouldn't just run away without taking his G-Force trans power band with him.
We must find him, Ace.
But who would want to kidnap a little kid like Pee-wee?
I suspect it was Galactor.
Then it must be tied up with another one of his plans to take over the Earth.
We don't know that yet. But three other boys Pee-wee's age also disappeared late last night.
You think it's possible that there's a connection with this big mechanical bug?
Pee-wee did have a big ugly beetle with him last night, but I told him he had to leave it outside.
Ace, go after that robot and find out whatever you can, but you're going to have to handle it on your own this time.
I will. G-Force! Transform! They're holding a little boy captive. Dr. Brighthead, my penetrator ray shows a little boy inside there.
What?
He seems to be unconscious.
That means we can't destroy the robot.
That's right. You better call off any backup aircraft on the way.
Red Impulse is almost there now. I'll have to contact them immediately.
All right, team, we have them in our sights. Prepare to fire on my command.
Red Impulse, this is Brighthead. Do not attack. Repeat, do not attack. There's a little boy inside the robot.
What?
Red Impulse, call off attack. Repeat, do not attack.
Isn't there anything we can do to support you, G-Force?
Thanks, but no thanks, Red Impulse. I think we can handle it all on our own this time. This is G-1. Do you read me clear, G-2?
Loud and clear.
We have to track down a robot that's been attacking the nuclear power station.
I'm ready.
Follow my signal and rendezvous with the team, G3.
Roger.
Let's go, G5. We don't have any time to waste.
Roger.
What's below?
Ace, do you think this could be one of Galactor's secret bases?
Report to Dr. Brighthead that these ancient ruins are being used as a camouflage. We'll have to be very careful going in there.
Guy in charge here. Tell him to come on out and show himself. You've got me mad now, and I want to know what's going on.
My, you're a spunky one, aren't you? Just the kind of kid we've been looking for, and I can tell you right now that Galactor will never let you go.
Is he behind all this?
I'm scared. Let me go.
Yeah.
They have destructive urges, but these Earthling children lose their courage in the face of danger. Captain, you know how to keep them quiet, don't you?
Mm-hmm.
You big jerks, you don't know who you're talking to. Now stand back and let me show you what the word courage really means. G-Force!
Uh-oh. I lost my transpower band. We're in a lot of trouble if I'm just a regular kid.
Oh!
I've captured the Earthling children, Mighty Galactor. What do you want me to do with them now? Good work, Lieutenant. This operation is proceeding even more smoothly than I had hoped it would. And now that we have the Earthling boys, I can proceed with the next step of our plan. My plan is to use their natural destructive impulses to operate robots, which will terrorize the Earth into submission. But I won't be needing the boys' bodies, Lieutenant. Only their brains. Now prepare the operating room and send the boys into surgery. Right away.
Ace, it looks as though you were right from the very beginning. Those robots do belong to Galactor. He seems to control the giant beetles by using a complex computer system that draws its power from the brains of the unconscious boys. Oh, brother, Galactor's really sunk low this time.
And Pee-wee can't transform without his power band.
Rescuing Pee-wee and the other three boys has got to be our top priority, team. Tonight is the night for you to sneak into the secret base and locate the children. They have to come out safely no matter what. Good luck to you and the whole team.
Thanks very much.
Hello there!
Sweet dreams!
Now, let's find the kid.
Okay, Ace.
I don't know how I know it, Aggie, but Pee-wee isn't far away now. We don't know what Galactor's plan is, so we've got to find him soon.
Right, but it'll be dangerous.
So what? That's never stopped us before.
Everything is ready, Mighty Galactor.
Good. Now I want you to test the brain of that troublesome boy first.
Yes, sir. Isolate them into individual capsules and prepare to operate. Ah! Guards, we have an intruder! Attack!
I hate to interrupt your party, but before you operate, you'll have to fight with G-Force.
How did you sneak in here?
Sneaking in is what we do best, Lieutenant, but we also like to win.
Fire!
Put those away and let's really fight.
I'll get Pee-wee. Pee-wee, let's go.
Aggie, you made it.
I think you forgot something, G4.
Hmm? Gee, thanks. Am I glad to see this?
Look out! Whoa!
G-Force, transform! Watch it!
Oh, no! Oh, my God, I've had enough of your hospitality! Oh.
Come on, Tommy, we gotta get you guys out of here.
Hey, what's happening here? Is this all real? I thought I was just having a bad dream.
There's the door. Now we gotta get out of here. Let's go, Ace.
G2, we're on our way out now. We're counting on you to give us a hand.
You got it.
Up to safety in the Phoenix, Pee-wee.
There, guards! Don't let them get away!
Can't you go any faster, Tommy?
The sooner we get up there, the more we'll be able to help.
No! No! Oh, no, you don't! Ah!
Looks like those beetle robots are heading right this way. Well, let's see how they like the bird missile. Wait, I didn't push a button.
Thanks, Red Impulse.
Roger, G-Force.
Lieutenant, it would appear that you have failed in your mission.
I am very sorry.
Sorry is not good enough. You have only one final duty. G-Force cannot be allowed to find any of my records, so you must destroy the base now!
If I am to destroy myself, I shall also destroy G-Force. For Galactor.
It's an earthquake! The ruins are sinking into the ground!
Dirk's down there!
Where's the nearest exit?
In a heap of trouble down there. Now that we're all safe, let's get over to him on the double.
You got it, Ace.
Those boulders nearly got us all that time. Hey, Dirk, that one was a pretty narrow escape.
We couldn't have gotten out without your help, Hootie. Thanks.
Yeah, and that goes double for me.
Gee, I never thought I'd actually get to meet the members of G-Force.
They make me want to turn over a new leaf.
But what happened to that funny-looking skinny kid who was with us back there?
Huh?
I didn't see any skinny kid. But I hope the three of you are more careful about the kind of bugs you pick up in the future so we can avoid adventures like this.
Or else do your insect hunting with the skinniest member of G-Force.
Oh!